Hello everyone, this is Yukti from Dancing Curve and welcome to your next tutorial, hashtag Ghar Pe Dance Corona. Today's style is belly dancing, of course because it has been requested by a few of our DC ladies, but you can be of any age, any gender, any body shape and you can still try this dance form. All that you need is a scarf or a coin belt that you can tie around your waist. You do not need any footwear. Let's begin. So the first thing that you have to learn is the basic belly dance posture. I'm keeping my feet in line with my hips, pushing my shoulder at the back. So this gets your chest a little high. From here, I'm going to tuck my tailbone inside, engaging my lower abs. And along with this, you have to get your hands to the side such that your elbows do not stick to your body but are a little far away. Along with this, I'm using my Brava hands where my thumb and my middle finger are closer to each other. Along with this, soften your knees a little bit and this is your basic belly dance posture. So the first thing that you have to do is push your hip to the side such that your body weight goes to the right and then switch to shift your weight to the left side. Once more, right, left, right and left. You have to keep your upper body in one place. Along with this, you need to learn the movement of pushing your hip forward and back, forward and back. When you go back, do not get your hips out. Keep your body in one line. Once more, going forward and back, forward and back. You're going to feel a nice stretch and a contraction in your core. So to go into a hip circle, I'm going to connect the hip slide and the forward and back movement to go slide, forward, slide, back. If I do it in one flow, it's going to look like this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. The next term is called as the hip drops and I'm also going to add kicks into it. So all that you have to do is soften your knees, get your right leg out on the toe and all that you have to do is straighten it a little bit to rise your hip and then drop it down. Once more, up and down. Remember that the left leg stays constantly bent. You are not going to straighten that leg to end up bouncing. Keep your head in one place, your body doesn't bounce, only your lower body is moving to go up, down and drop and drop. Now along with this I'm going to add a kick. So go up, drop, up, kick on the second drop. Now when I kick I'm also going to twist my heel to the side. Once more, going drop, kick, drop, kick. Moving on to the interior hip circle, all that you have to do is get into a hip lift to your right side, push your hips forward, let your knees naturally bend, switch the side and push your hips at the back, avoid arching your back over here. Once more, right, forward, left, back. Now make it in one flow, going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You're going to feel more pressure in your core for this circle. The next term is called as vertical figure eight. All that you have to do is rise any one leg up on the toe. Naturally, that hip is going to come up. Again, you will feel a contraction in your oblique. Now, all that you have to do is push your hip out and place your leg down. Switch to get the opposite leg up on the toe. Push your hip out and place it down. While lifting your leg up, and facing it to the side. Avoid any movement in your ankle. Keep it nice and straight. Once more, going up, drop, up, and drop. Now, joining it and making it in a flow, I'm going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Use the hands. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. The next step is called as a shoulder shimmy. All that you have to do is get any one shoulder in the front, put it back, other shoulder back. Avoid rotating it and avoid twisting it downwards. It has to go forward, 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 and forward. Now hit it with more energy, going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Faster, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The next term is called as traveling twists. All that you have to do is first twist your hips. So any one hip will go forward, then switch, right, and left. Now create accents to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's add footwork to this. Go up on your toes, step any one leg in front, cross the other leg slightly at the back to go to the side, back, forward, back, 7, neutral. Now go on the opposite side, forward, 2, 3, 4, travel, 6, 7, 8. Let's add the twists to this. All that you have to do is hit the hip in front when you step the leg in front, forward, push it back, forward, back, 5, 6, 7, neutral, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. The next step is called as the Egyptian. Soften your knees and step your right leg on the toe. Come back, left, and back. Remember not to straighten your leg all the way. Keep your knees soft throughout. Come back, step, and back. Along with this, I'm going to twist my hips. So I'm going up and down, up and down. Now when I hit my hip up, I'm going to aim hitting it at the diagonal top corner of the left side. And down, opposite, down, right, and left, and down. Along with this, use your Brava hands. Right hand, right leg, left hand up on the head, just touch it. Up, switch, left, and right, and left. I hope you guys have finished learning all the terms, so let's begin with the choreography. Step your left leg out, right leg in, left leg out, and then right leg on the toe where your body is slightly facing the left side diagonally. Along with this, use your Brava hands to go down, up, 3, 4, where your wrists come close to each other. Along with this, I'm going to use the exterior hip circle. I'm going to do only 1.5, going forward, back, forward, and neutral. So together it's going to look like 1, 2, 3, 4. From here, I'm going to do 2 hip drops going into the vertical figure 8. So drop, 6, step the right leg out, 7, 8, with the Brava hands coming down. From here, step your left leg in the front and come back. Along with this, keep your hands to the side. Go into a shimmy, 2, 3, go 4, and with the chin going up, down. So once more, 1, 2, 3, 4, and from here I'm going to do the hip twist. So right, left, center. The counts are 5, 6, and from there go right shoulder up, switch, then lift your chest and drop. So together it's going to look like 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, and tuck, 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 tuck. From here, I'm going to repeat the first bar going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Going into the shimmy, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then hit your right shoulder up, wave that arm all the way up while the left hand comes down. Going into 2 wrist rolls. Along with the wrist roll, I'm going to do the interior hip circle. Starting from the left, back, right, forward, left, back, right, forward. So together it's going to look like roll and roll. Let's try it once again from the shimmy, going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, 7, 8. From here, we're going to do the traveling twist to the left and right. So get your left arm up in the air and hold your head with your right hand to go left, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Center, switch your hands to go right, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. On the eighth count, step your left leg further at the back to push your weight on it. And from here, we're going to do the hip drop and kick to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Along with this, I'm going to keep my left hand up, right hand down in a diagonal, where my palm is going to face down, up, down, up, 5, 6, 7, 8. So together it's going to look like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, I'm going to walk forward doing the Egyptian. So step your right leg in front, going right hand, switch, step your left leg in front, going left. From here, I'm going to take a pivot turn, which means I'm going to step my right leg in front, left leg will be stationary, and come back with your right leg on the toe to go pose on 7 and 8. Let's try the whole choreography from the top. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, and ta 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 ta. Repeat, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, travel left, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, center right, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, back hip drop, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, Egyptian, 1, 2, 3, turn, 5, 6, 7, pose. Try it several times on music and then record yourself. Tag Dancing Curve with the hashtag CurpeDanceCorona.